Get ready for the dictation. Dictation will start in 5 seconds. Start. In this connection, I am also happy to hear what the defense minister said yesterday in one of his public meetings, namely that the government of India is contemplating to create a setup in our villages wherein our panchayats will be functioning more or less on the lines of parliament. Unfortunately, he did not elaborate that point further, and the press has not thrown any more light on what that exactly means. But if it means that the panchayats will be in charge of the resources that are available in the villages, that they will be in a position to determine how best the productive efforts in the villages are to be directed and in what direction, determine what targets are to be achieved and when the production is there and there is a surplus to be exchanged with other centers in the country, that the panchayats will have their say in the matter on what terms this surplus will be exchanged with other centers in the country. Then I think a very valuable step forward in the direction of building our economy on a decentralized basis will have been taken. We have always taken the view, sir, that if planning is to succeed in our country and if there is not going to be any regimentation of our productive activity and forces, what is necessary is that the common man should have a voice in determining the economic policies and in formulating the economic plans of development, and should have also his say in determining on what terms a village or a group or an industry should be working for the development of economy as a whole. In other words, some amount of competition, some amount of bargaining power is to be generated in the lowest strata of our society and in the lowest rung of our economy, so that with the help of that bargaining power, under the overall influence and policy of the Planning Commission, it may be possible for us to develop our economy in a manner which satisfies both the interests and the requirements of the nation as well as the aspirations of the pupil. When pupil feel that they also have their say in the formulation of policies and programs, and that such policies and programs are not something which is dictated from New Delhi, but are those which have been worked out by their own efforts of and as a result of their own deliberations, to that extent these plans are a part of their efforts in the development of their regions, of their own crafts, their own industries, and their own skills. Stop.